Hi there, it's Kevin Ward with Yes Masters Real Estate Success Training, helping you get more yeses and more successes in your business and in your life. And today I actually want to talk to you about success. I want to talk to you about some things that you can do in your life on a daily basis, on a regular basis, that will help increase the level of achievement you have in your life and the level of fulfillment you have in your life, which when you put it all together is what I call, or what most people would call, simply success. Now, for the last 3 years, I've really personally, and some of you that know my story, know my journey, in the last 3 years, everything in my life has turned around. And what happened was 3 years ago, I'd been living I want to call it a state of survival. After the economic downturn and all of that, like so many people, I went into a state of survival. I survived pretty well most of the time, not always, sometimes better than others. But the bottom line was I got into a security, a safety zone, a comfort zone of just surviving. And about 3 years ago, I just looked at my life and I'm going like, you know what? How many more years do I want to be at this level? And it's like, not one more year. It's time to do something different. And so I started reinvesting myself in personal growth and development, and at a level I've never done before. I started studying successful people in all industries and all over the world, people that I've seen that have achieved at high levels, not only a business success or financial success, but a personal success, a personal fulfillment, at making a difference in the world, making a difference in adding value to other people's lives. And what are the things that they have and that they do that make them achieve at a level that lets them feel that or experience that, what we typically call success? And here's the one overarching thing that I have discovered about success in all my observation, all my study, and all my experience, and that is that at the heart of it all, success is a habit. And what I mean by that is that being successful is literally about a set of habits. It's a way that we behave. It's a way that we act. It's a way that we think throughout the day, every single day, that over time causes us to either be extremely successful or extremely mediocre. And in fact, as Jim Rohn used to say, he would say that small errors in judgment repeated consistently will lead to disaster. Now think about that. Small errors in judgment repeated consistently will lead to disaster. And what he meant was, it's not the huge mistakes, it's that we make little decisions that create little habits in our life that keep us from being successful, that keep us stuck in mediocrity. Well, if that's true, then the opposite is true also, and that is that little judgments of good decisions repeated daily will lead to massive success. And here's what I have observed, and that is that people that are achieving at high levels, people that are experiencing success and abundance and that sense of fulfillment, they've developed habits of success, and they've developed daily rituals that support their success. And I want to share with you something that I developed a couple of years ago that I call my daily eights. And what I did was I was watching people who have been extremely successful, and I was looking at what do they do, the habits that they have, and I found some things that tend to be across the board. Now, they're not all for everybody, but these rituals that I do every single day have made a profound impact in my life. I was sharing them with a group of people recently, and they said, man, you need to share that with more people. So I decided today I was going to do a video on what I've developed, what I call the daily eights. And the daily eights are my habits, my daily rituals that have made massive difference in the level of success and personal fulfillment and just the joy and the enjoyment in my life of what I'm doing every single day. And I wanted to share them with you today. There's 9 of them that are what I call the daily eights. And here's what I'm going to tell you. If you'll commit yourself to these daily activities, making these a ritual, a part of your life, they'll make a huge impact. If you want to do one at a time, do all of them, do some of them, pick and choose, whatever you do, they're going to help you. So I want to just share with you what those daily activities are, the daily rituals that I do. The first 7 of them I do pretty much every morning. So the first thing is, when I wake up in the morning, the very first thing that I do every morning is hydrate my cells. Now, what does that mean? It means I drink water. And here's what we have learned, and I've learned this from some of the people that I've been studying and learning, and that is, especially in North America, we are chronically dehydrated. We just don't drink enough water. We drink too much other stuff. We drink too much Coke. We drink too much Pepsi. We drink too much energy drink. We drink too much Gatorade. We drink too much coffee. We drink too much tea. We drink too much alcohol. Whatever it is, anything that you have to metabolize, your body metabolizes, or that's got anything artificial in it, is not hydrating your body, it's dehydrating your body. And of course, the worst of all is probably sugar. Sugar, alcohol, caffeine, those are the real things that can really wreck your energy level and your ability to perform at a high level. Well, when you hydrate your cells, you give your body energy. What do they say? Two-thirds of your body is water. So every day, the first thing when I wake up in the morning, I drink a full glass of water, typically 16, 20 ounces, a full, either a water bottle or a glass of water. I drink a whole glass of water first thing in the morning. And then throughout the morning, I'm constantly hydrating and through the day. Now, here was what I set out as a goal, and I learned this just in studying high performers and high performance athletes, people who need high energy to be able to perform at their best. And what I discovered was, and I learned this from others, is that if you will drink 1 ounce of water per pound of body weight, your body is going to be optimally hydrated. Now that sounds like a lot, but I drink, for example, I weigh about 165 pounds, so I drink about 165 ounces of water a day. Now if you take a 20 ounce glass, that's 8 ounces or 8 glasses a day. So whatever it is for you, if you'll do that. Now they say, 12 ounce glasses a day. If you're doing that, you're getting hydrated way beyond the average. But here's the thing, your brain, mostly water. Your body, mostly water. When you're hydrated, your energy level is better, you think clearer, a lot of the headaches that we have are because we're dehydrated. And when you feel thirsty, most of the time physiologists say that you're actually already dehydrated. So if you want to perform at a higher level, have better focus, better energy, number one, hydrate yourself. In fact, I recently just completely quit drinking coffee. Why? Because I was just pumping my body full of caffeine every day. And does it give you some buzz, some energy? Yeah, caffeine always does that. But it also does some other things that were not benefiting me. And one of the negatives is that caffeine is a diuretic. Caffeine actually pulls water, dehydrates you. And it makes a huge difference both with my voice. It makes a huge difference with my energy, with my focus, with my clarity. If you got the jitters when you do caffeine, taking yourself off caffeine and hydrating better will make a huge difference in your performance. Number two, the second thing I did every single day when I wake up is oxygenate your blood. Now the key word here is breathe. And one of the things that if you ever just pay attention to yourself and just notice right now as you're watching this video, are you breathing? And here's the reality is you're probably breathing very, very shallow. In fact, when you speak, when you talk to people, a lot of times we don't breathe good. And we breathe from here instead of where our diaphragm is, which is down here. So when you breathe, they say, breathe it. Let's let your stomach go out. Relax it. I don't know if you can see this on the camera here. And let your stomach go in when you breathe out. And every day, every morning when I first wake up, I do breathing exercises, which means I just do deep diaphragmatic breaths where I just fill myself with oxygen. Now, what is oxygen? Oxygen is what makes your blood work for your body. When your blood is highly oxygenated, your brain works better, your lungs, your whole body functions better. You heal faster, you get better circulation, and the blood as it pumps through all the parts of your body, you get more oxygen in your body, you're gonna perform better. And so you do deep breathing exercises. Literally, just take a deep breath, the diaphragmatic breath. When you breathe in deep, always breathe in through your nose because your nose has little filters in there to filter out all the crap. And it also keeps your throat from becoming dehydrated, and just breathe out. And if you'll do that, and I mean, there are a lot of different breathing rituals or ways that you can do it. Yoga is great for breathing exercises because that's a big part of yoga is your breath. And why is that so important? Why is yoga focused so much on breath? Because they discovered that energy and health and fitness, how you breathe has a whole lot to do with how your body performs. Now, several other things your breathing does. Breathing releases stress. When you take deep breaths in, you do that, it relaxes you, it relieves stress. And when you do it, just take that deep breath in, and just as you breathe out, just feel the tension breathing out of your body. It's extremely, extremely powerful. Oxygenating your blood. If you'll oxygenate your blood, it's gonna feed your brain better, it's gonna increase your performance, it's gonna increase a lot of the good hormone, a lot of the good, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nutritionist, it's gonna, I can't remember what it's called, but the things that make your brain feel endorphins, increase good breathing. Helps release endorphins. It helps, which actually is like a good drug that's created by your body. So oxygenate, breathe, take deep breaths. When you get stressed, most of us stop breathing. We hold our breath. Breathe. and that energy that gives you and the clarity it gives you of thinking and focus is very, very powerful. Number three is meditate your mind. About 3 years ago, I started meditating. I've done it a little bit off and on for the last several years, but really over the last 3 years, I've gotten more and more consistent at meditating, and now I virtually meditate every single day. Now, I do it different amounts. I try to meditate a minimum of 21 minutes a day. In fact, I use a timer. So hydrating my cells, make sure I drink an ounce of water. So what I do is 1 ounce, 1 ounce per pound of body weight. So that's what I do. Okay, oxygenating your blood, I try to do 3 times a day where I do some really deep breathing exercises where I really even get lightheaded from it. And just do that. I try to do that at least 3 times a day. Meditate your mind. I do it a minimum of 21 minutes every single day. And I listen to some nice meditation music, just close my eyes, relax, just get comfortable. And then I just focus on breathing. It's part of the oxygenating my blood. And then I just breathe. And there's a ton of different things that you can do out there, different meditation stuff. You can do it as part of yoga. You can do it just sitting and quietly focusing on your breath. You can use mantras. There's a lot of different ways you can do it. But the thing is, the goal of meditation is to quiet your mind and to get present in the moment, to really get centered. And one of the things I teach my coaching members, real estate agents, is that I teach them to build what's called a real estate vortex, which is a powerful pulling force to attract business to you. But the whole concept of a vortex is it's this very powerful swirling motion, right? Well, you want to be the eye of the storm. And in the eye of the storm, everything is calm. Everything is centered. Everything is peaceful. And so in your business and in your life, if you can maintain that centeredness, if you can maintain that calmness, it's extremely powerful. As all the stuff can be going crazy and hectic around you. But if you're able to stay centered and in control and in the moment, then you can handle it. And that meditation is just a way to quiet your mind, quiet all the, what I call the mind chatter, or sometimes I call it mind frick, that mental friction whenever you're like thinking all these different thoughts and fears kicking in and worry and stress and all this, and just get in the present moment, get rid of all of those thoughts, get rid of all that mind chatter, and for even starting with 3 minutes a day, and then working your way up to 5 minutes, and then 7 minutes, and then 10 minutes, and then 15 minutes. And I'm at 21 minutes a day that I do consistently. Some days I can do more. Some days if I meditate late in the afternoon, some days I'll fall asleep and then I'll wake up and I'm like, whoa, I don't know what happened. But guess what? Totally refreshed. And when you'll take that time to do it, just to still yourself, it re-energizes you, it refocuses you, it recharges your emotional batteries. And if you do it a minimum of 1 time a day, and sometimes 2 or 3 times a day will really help, and it doesn't have to be some long marathon thing, literally for 3 minutes, if you just get quiet and center, just focus on your breath, and maybe have some quiet music going, or silence is fine too, and just relax, quiet your mind. Sometimes it's hard to quiet your mind because your mind keeps going like, I don't like it quiet around here. I like some noise. I like some chatter. But the more you learn to discipline yourself, the more focused you get, the more center you get, and then the more clear-headed you are when you go back, go into your day or go back into your day. Number four is every morning is I state my truth. And what I mean by state your truth is daily declarations. And you've probably heard of the idea of using affirmations. And I prefer the word daily declarations. T. Harv Eker talks about using declarations. And the reason I like declarations better than affirmations is because a declaration is just, it's just more powerful than an affirmation. An affirmation is like, okay, yeah, it's good, it's positive. But a declaration can be that same good, positive thought, but it's stated with conviction, with power. And so, you know, there's a lot of great classic declarations. Declarations like, everything I need is within me now. One of my favorite declarations, or some of my favorites, is I am infinitely powerful. I am totally confident. Everything I need is within me now. There's the daily declaration, I am the best. I am the greatest. I mean, look, Muhammad Ali says if you guys know Muhammad Ali, one of the greatest boxers, heavyweight boxers of all time, back in the 60s and 70s. His big claim to fame was, I am the greatest, I am the greatest. And here's what he said. He said, I used to say that over and over hundreds of times a day before I even knew that I really was the greatest. Now even just notice what I just said. Notice what he said. He said, I used to say it even before I knew it was true. Okay, the power of that is off the charts. Now I just had something very interesting happen. I use timers. I use timers for my meditation. And one of them is a 21-minute timer. And I'll just show it to you since it just went off in the middle of this video here. And I don't know if you can see it in the video, but I use a timer. And I use these timers. And if you can see that, let me see if you can get it. I think you can see that. Is that's a 21-minute timer. And I have different timers set for the different things that I do here. One of them is 21 minutes a day of meditation. I also have a 7-minute timer, which I'll just show you now. And hang on, I need to turn this off so that it doesn't buzz again during this video. But when it comes to stating my truth, those daily declarations, I spend 7 minutes a day, 7 minutes a day in declarations. And I've got a whole list of declarations that I do every day. Some of them are very personal, some are about my business, some are about who I am, my definite major purpose, what Napoleon Hill talks about in Think and Grow Rich. Those are declarations that I make every single day where I am stating my truth. These are the things that are true for me at my best, in my best self. This is the truth that I want to embrace, the truth that I want to claim, the truth of who I want to become and the value I want to add to the world is every single day stating it. And it's extremely powerful. There's a great book by Jack Canfield called The Success Principles, where he talks a lot about affirmation. And I think the word he uses is actually affirmations, but it's extremely powerful as he talks about your declarations. You want them to be present tense. You want them to be first person, and you want them to be extremely powerful. Like instead of just saying, I am powerful, say, I am infinitely powerful. Instead of saying, I am confident, say, I am totally confident. I am powerfully disciplined. Instead, if you want to become more disciplined, don't just say, I am disciplined, I am disciplined. Say, I am powerfully disciplined. Because those words that modify it just give it more strength, and the conviction and the emotion that you attach to it makes it very, very powerful. So state your truth. Number five, I spend 7 minutes a day doing that. And then number five is one of the most important things I do every single day, and that is create my future. I think it was Abraham Lincoln who said, the best way to predict your future is to create it. Now think about that. The best way to predict your future is to create it. How do you create your future? Well, I do two things every single day to create my future. One is every single day is planning your day, just actually planning your day out. And then two is visualizing. These are two things I do every day, is visualizing my ideal future, which means every day I review my goals. And as I review my goals, I visualize myself having accomplished my goals. Now, here's something that's really powerful. First, let me go back to this planning your day. I actually set my timer, and I spend 7 minutes every morning planning my day. Now, I use a thing that I call my daily map, my daily massive action plan. And what I do with that is every single day, I take yesterday's daily massive action plan and this one, and plus any notes that I've made and so forth, and I plan out my day. Okay, I've got appointments locked into my schedule, coaching calls or whatever it is that I have in my schedule for the day. And then I take what I've got locked in, and then I just plan out the rest of my day. It takes me 7 minutes. Why? Because I work on it. And I've got yesterday's things, if there's anything left that I didn't finish, got my key focus areas and all that, and I plan today so it's going to be productive. And then the second thing I do is I review my goals every single day. Now, here's what I do, is that's 7 minutes. I set my timer for 7 minutes. And I have my goals laid out, and I just review my goals. Now, I have a list, and every year I create a list of at least 100 goals of things I want to accomplish that year, things I'd like to do, things I'd like to have, things I'd like to become, places I'd like to go. Anything that is a goal or important to me, I have one-year goals, and some of them will be 30-day goals, and one-year goals, and I've got longer-term goals. This year, I was looking at it just this morning, and so far this year, I have accomplished 58 goals that I set for myself at the beginning of this year. And I look back at that, and I'm going, wow. Now, as I'm recording this video, we're 10 months into the year. It's nearly the end of October. And so as I was looking at it, I'm like, wow, I never would have dreamed how much I have accomplished. And I'll tell you, over the last 2 years, it has massively changed my life and the accomplishments I've made. Why? Because I'm creating my future by visualizing it every day, and things that I didn't know how I was going to accomplish it. But I've accomplished it because it was in my brain. It was in the program there, my subconscious mind, because I'd been visualizing achieving those goals. So every day you want to create your future, here's how you do it. Plan that day and visualize the future beyond today. And every single day, if you do it, it's extremely powerful. Number six, and by the way, I'm spending as much time explaining it as some of this does to do. That takes 14 minutes, okay? The sixth thing I do is activate my body. And by this just means, look, if most of us Americans, we need to move more. Have there been times you just got out of the practice of exercising because you're too busy? If you're not exercising, you're stealing your life. And people are like, well, I don't have time to exercise. Look, here's the reality. If you spend 30 minutes to an hour exercising every single day consistently, 4 or 5 days a week where you're consistent in it, it will literally add, however much time you spend doing it, it will double the amount of time it will add to your life. So if you spend an hour of exercising a day, it's gonna add 2 hours worth of energy to your day. So that if you're going like 12 hours and after 12 hours you're wasted, hey, spend some time exercising and it'll add 2 or 3 hours to your day. So it's an investment of your time when you exercise. So literally every day I have a practice because I'm not a big workout guy. And a lot of times like you, I'm busy, I travel a lot. So I don't always get time to do the big exercises, but every day at a minimum, I have 21 minutes a day at least that I am going to move. And it may be some days, it may be yoga. Some days it's just some good stretching. Some days it's high intensity training where I do some things. And they're just simple. I mean, you literally can stand anywhere and just do that. Just do a bunch of push-ups, some sit-ups, and some crunches. You can do P90X type stuff. Just do high intensity activities. Do resistance exercises. Do burpees if you know what burpees are. Exercise to just get your body moving, get your blood pumping. Makes a huge difference in your energy level, the way you feel, and not only that, you live longer. I mean, pure and simple. Everything that I'm showing you here, guys, they have also attached virtually every one of these things to longevity. If you want to live longer and still feel good about it and feel good physically and have everything working, these are things that you do every day that'll help you with it. The seventh thing that I do every morning is educate your brain. Now, since I've started doing this, guys, it's changed everything. I've spent a lot more time and money investing in my personal growth and development. But one of the things that all of us can do anywhere, anytime is read. And if you're not reading every day, you're not growing. People go like, well, what's been the biggest thing for you that's helped your business explode in the last two or three years? And here it is. I'm not more talented than other people. I've just outgrown other people. When I started real estate, same thing. I wasn't the most talented guy out there. I wasn't more talented than other agents. I outgrew them. I grew, I studied, I implemented. And when that happens, if you'll just read your brain, as your mind grows, this is like supplements for your brain. It's like feeding your brain is reading good books. And for me, it is a minimum of 21 minutes a day that I'm gonna read a good book. I'm gonna sit down and read a good book, preferably I try to do that in the morning because I'm fresher and my mind is just retains it better. If I read at night, I tend to fall asleep. I do read at night too. And if you'll read every day, it's amazing. If you just read 21 minutes a day, okay, and you did that literally every day for 30 days, that's, what does that come out to? 21 times, that's a lot of time. That's literally a book, at least a book a month. And how many books have you been reading? It's probably, for a lot of you, that's 2 books a month. And my commitment is to read a book a week. And I've been, one of my mentors, Brendan Burchard, for 18 years in a row, he's read a book a week, every single week, and hasn't missed a week. And I'm just like, I can do that. And I've been reading a book every single week. And it's very, very powerful in your brain. As you're learning and as you're growing, you get better, you get more confident, you get more focused. It's just amazing what that growth does to you. All of these are things that I do. I call it my pre-game ritual. Before I hit my day, I want to do all of these things in the morning if I can. And this is less than 90 minutes worth of stuff. Now, you can compress it like if your meditation, if you compress that down into just 7 minutes even to start the day. And you can do your breathing at the same time. A lot of times I do my breathing in the shower. That's right. Why? Because I'm standing there and I can breathe in the shower. I can breathe. And so I just take deep breaths. Just try to not do it when my head's under the water. I don't have to wash my hair, but you know what I mean. Sorry, I'm having a little bit of fun here today. At night, I do 2 things. Now, you don't have to do this at night, but I do it at night. And that is number 8 is appreciate your blessings. Every single night, I keep a journal. And I'm going to tell you, this has been probably the single biggest thing that's changed my life is journaling every single day. And I've just been amazed at the people, at high achievers throughout history who journaled every single day. And it's just been a part of what they do and a part of their life. And you can get a journal. This is my favorite size. I like this size right here. There's a Moleskine. This is a Markings journal. You can find them on Amazon. And I like this size. This is the one I've been using at night. And every night I write down 5 things I'm grateful for. A minimum of 5 things I'm grateful for every single night. And 200, let's see, last night was 219 days ago, I made a commitment to start journaling every day, no matter what, no matter where I was. That was 219 days ago. I have journaled for the last 219 days. I have missed 11 days of journaling. Now, what's powerful about it is it's become a habit. And so I'll journal five things that I'm grateful for that day. And then the last thing is I celebrate my wins. And what that means is every night I journal my five or more, at least five, of my biggest wins that day. What are the things that I did that day that I was most proud of? What were the great things that I accomplished or that I did? And it doesn't have to be big, you know, it may not, but it's the five most significant things that I did. And I'm just acknowledging the good things that I'm doing. And subconsciously, when you celebrate your wins, your subconscious goes like, wow, that felt great. I want to do more of that. See, when you focus on something like your wins, instead of going through the day and then at the end of the day going like, oh, today was horrible. Oh, I got so much to do tomorrow. Oh, if you end your day that way, you go to bed and you go to sleep stressed out. Well, that's not powerful. That's not great for recharging your batteries at night. But when you go to bed grateful and thinking about the great things in your life, guess what? When you're grateful, you open up your heart and your mind and your soul and your subconscious to receive more good stuff, because the universe will just bring it to you because of your gratitude. And when you're celebrating your wins, your subconscious goes like, yes, give me more of that, instead of celebrating and talking about my stress and my negatives, my defeats. Focus on your positives, not your negatives. Why? It's the law of focus. What we focus on tends to expand. We tend to get in our life what we think about, what we focus on every day. Earl Nightingale taught that in the book, The Strangest Secret, years and years ago, when he talked about that if you'll focus on the things you want, not the things you don't want, you'll get more of the things you want. It's called celebrating your wins. And those nine practices, I call them my daily eights, every single day doing those will make a massive, massive difference in your life. Hydrate your body. Oxygenate your blood. You got to breathe. You got to put good stuff in, good air in, good water in. Meditate your mind, putting good thoughts in your brain with stating your truth, creating your future both by planning today and by visualizing your goals and your future, activating your body by energizing yourself, taking care of your physical body, exercising, educating your brain by reading, listening to good CDs, motivational stuff. All of that is very, very powerful. Appreciating your blessings, journaling every day, five things you're grateful for, and then celebrating your wins by writing down your five greatest victories of the day every day. They don't have to be big. They just have to be worthy of celebration. And you can find, even if you woke up this morning like, first thing I thought was, yes, then I started with a positive thought. That's a victory. I write that down. Whatever it is that you're celebrating, and as you do these daily eights, what happens is you're putting good things into your mind, putting good things in your body, putting good things in your life, and the more you put in, the more you'll get out, and the more the universe will bring to you. So this is Kevin Ward with Yes Masters Real Estate Success Training, and here's what I want you to do is embrace your life, engage every opportunity, and always expect yes.